In this video, we will see how to copy a board for measurements. In this document, I have noted measurements of rocker, thickness, and outline of a board by taking the distance measurements along the curve of the bottom stringer. I move the document, open Shape 3D. We will start on a new board. I will just put the right length. Board measured along the stringer is 5 feet 8.6 inches. And to insert the measurements, I'm going to go to Guidelines and choose Guidelines Wizard. I'm writing down the measurements I took at different distances from the tail and distance from the nose. For the outline, I'm going to write them down one by one, 0.25 inch. I use the tab key to move from one box to another. Here we have the max width, which was 18.7 inch at 32.6 from the tail. Then I didn't take a measurement at 24 inch from the nose, so I skip. At 18 inch we were at 15.4. Then I move on to the profile measurements. For the rocker we were at 2.17 inch. The minimum of the rocker, so the 0 point, was at 34 inch in from the tail. Then I did not take a measurement at 24 inch from the nose, and at 18 we were at 0.65. And finally the thickness, 0.5 inch at the tail. The maximum thickness was 2.35 inch at 33.4 from the tail. Then, no measurement at 24 inch. Here we have noted all the measures taken. Sir, it was along the stringer. The length was indeed 5 feet 8.6 inches. And if we only do that, it will just add guidelines along the curves. But if the curve to adjust to these guidelines, we must check the automatic fitting box, then OK. Sir, I did not check the automatic fitting box for the outline, so it asks me if I want to do it. I will say yes. And there it does the automatic adjustment. We see that it's not bad for the outline. For the curve of the stringer below, it's not bad, but it's not perfect. So to adjust the curve, I select the points. If I click, it will select the markers first. So I press the Shift and Control keys, and it will select the control point first. And there I can slightly modify the curve by hand. It's sometimes faster and better than using the automatic adjustment. Then to see the thickness, I go into thickness mode, and I see here the curve with the marks. It's close to the guidelines, but the curve is not very clean, so I adjust it by hand. We will notice that with this method where I took the measurements of X along the bottom stringer curve, is not the method that gives the best precision, because here the length along the stringer is 5 feet 8.6 inches. But as I modify the curve below a little, the developed length along the stringer will be modified. So it is not the most precise method. The most precise method is actually measuring the board along a straight line. So that requires either a very large ruler or a graduated floor. And at that point we're going to take the rocker measurement along that straight line. And not thickness measurements, but the deck height measurements from the ground. By taking X distances from the back and the front along a straight line. So for example, if I start again with the same board but with measurements taken along a straight line, and I do guideline wizard again, you can see that it remembered the guidelines I entered. But this time I'm going to do it along a straight line. The length then is 5 feet 8.0 inches. So on a straight line, in fact the rocker at the back hardly changes. But it's at the front where there is more curvature that it will start to be different. Here we had 0.6 inch, 1.3, 2.4, 3.2, and there's still 4.4. There will not be the thickness but the distance between the ground and the deck. So it changes quite a bit. I recheck automatic fitting. Do I want to replace the current guidelines? Yes. Here we see that the curve below is about the same as the previous time. And on the other hand, now we see that there are guidelines on the stringer deck curve and no longer on the thickness. As before, I can improve the automatic adjustment, which is not always perfect, including the stringer deck curve. So now to copy the slices, you have the choice. Either you can, for example, copy them from a photo of a section of a surfboard, or you can also take measurements and put them in a file, for example CSV, and import them with the function guideline import guideline. Here, for example, these are measurements taken on the center slice of another surfboard. I'm going to import them. We can see that it's a surfboard that doesn't have the same thickness or width, but it matter. We can still use the automatic fitting function, which adjusted the curve on the guidelines and then resized it to the right width and thickness. Then on a copy the rear, I have the measurements of a slice at 12 inch from the tail, so I'm going to move that 1 to 12 from the tail. And I'm going to import the guidelines. So that's the one. I do automatic fitting. Here I'm going to insert a new slice at 12 inch from the nose and import the guidelines. This is it. Automatic fitting. There you have it. We were able to copy the board, and the result is good and fast. Goodbye.